Very good evening to all. I hope I am clearly audible and visible clearly. There will be two sessions, one today and another tomorrow, in the form of two parts. First, to quickly do a synopsis of FMT subject. So today our major focus will be to toxicology part, and tomorrow the major focus will be towards FM part. Got it? So before starting the session, a quick brief about the upcoming batches. NEET PG 2023 batches have been started in the form of live session batches. Then currently the offer is going on regarding the pricing, and with every plus subscription, get access both live and recorded. Then you can take the benefits of iconic subscription. An Academy Lite means the question bank can be utilized for your as well as FMG, and this is the free test calendar targeting your FMG exams in particular. So subject wise questions are already there, prepared by the educators on respective date and time. You can attend those questions. Then batches on UPSC CMS revision have been started. The exam is on 17th July. This is your target next 2023 course, which has been started on 25th of May itself. Then other batch courses launched in the course of time. Then you can take the benefits of NEET PG previous year question bank as well as FMG previous year question. Both have been updated in the question. Then prof based courses targeting your prof one have already been started, and likewise other profs will also be covered. This pricing and all you can check out. We are good to go. Let us start with our session. Clearly audible and visible now. Dr. G, how many sessions? In YouTube, there will be two sessions, one today and another tomorrow on the same time, at the same time, that is 8 o'clock. Then I will be taking few special classes for all the students, which type sessions. On 1st, 2nd and 3rd of June, most likely in the same time slot, 8 o'clock in the evening, that all the students can attend these. Yeah. So let us start with our session. The questions are numerous and the questions are simple. Go on asking the questions quickly. Let us cover maximum things in relation to toxicology aspect. You can put your answers in the live chat window. Passing off greenish urine is suggestive of poisoning by. Take the best answer quickly. 5 to 10 seconds for each question. Green color urine. Green color. You know green color urine. So actually, it is not passing off greenish urine, but you read now. Suppose the person has passed normal urine. Within some time, this normal urine can convert into green color. And what is this phenomena called? This phenomena is called carboluria. This phenomena of carboluria is associated with carbolic acid poisoning. That is your phenol. In FMG exams itself, they have asked, what is the reason for this color change? This urine is kept in air. In air, what is present? Oxygen. In the presence of oxygen, what is there? Oxidation of phenolic metabolites. Now I'll start with pH alphabets. What are the metabolites which on oxidation give rise to this green urine? P for pyroketichol. Recall ho raha na? For pyroketichol. H for hydroquinone. Remember the name of the metabolites which on oxidation give rise to normal straw color urine being converted into greenish urine. The phenomena being called carboluria. Associated with phenol, one of the most important corrosive acids from where questions are always picked. Answer this one. Ochronosis is seen in chronic poisoning by which of the following? Again, the answer goes with carbolic acid. But here, the case will be a case of chronic carbolic acid poisoning. chronic phenol poisoning. In cases of chronic poisoning, what happens? This phenol has a tendency to get accumulated in different areas of the body like skin, sclera, cornea, and cartilage. And when it accumulates particularly in corneal and cartilage areas, this deposition is referred to as ochronosis, which is also associated with a biochemical defect that is called L-captonuria. L-captonuria as well as phenol poisoning, that too chronic type, can lead to ochronosis feature. These are the two differentials of your ochronosis, means pigmentations of corneal and cartilaginous cells. Correct? Which of the following is an OPC insecticide? All these are old questions of FMG exam sets. One liner question. Which of the following is an organophosphorus group of pesticide? Answer goes with malathion. So OPCs are basically pesticides having phosphate groups, and they are divided into alkyl phosphates and aryl phosphate. What is the list of aryl phosphates? This is easy to remember, in the form of PP. They are your aryl phosphates, where P for parathion, another P for peroxon, D for diazinon, which comes in market in the name of TIC 20, and C for chlorpyrifos. Now for any PG or as well as FMG exam, OPC group of pesticides, the features of OPC poisoning, all these are very important questions. So one of the questions is, all of the following are alkyl phosphate except. Usually the answer comes with parathion. List of alkyl phosphate is very long. Agents will be like malathion and all. So yes, malathion is a OPC pesticide. What about other options? Propoxer as well as carbaryl. These are two pesticides which come under carbamate group of insecticides. Carbamate group of agricultural poisons. What is Endrin, DDT as well as BHC? They are not OPCs. They are organochlorine group of agricultural poisons. They come under organochlorine groups. Endrins, BHC and DDT. Correct? The classification of agricultural poisons and this whole entity is very important. What we'll be doing in our special classes on 1st, 2nd and 3rd of June, we'll be trying to revise all these important poisons. Theory of these. And any other topic which you find to be difficult to revise or you are not able to recapitulate, do let me know in my Telegram group. I'll be covering those things on 1st, 2nd and 3rd of June in free live special classes on Unacademy app. Answer this one. Acrodynia is associated with. This question was asked in NEET PG exams too. Acrodynia is associated with chronic mercurial poisoning, which is also called as pink disease, swift disease. Other names are pink disease and swift disease. Where what happens is painful, pink color, puffy. Puffy matlab swollen lesions, mainly of the foot area. Mainly of the foot. Answer this. Judicial hanging is a method of execution of a condemned criminal. Cause of death in such case is mostly due to. This is a recent question of your exam. Answer goes with cervical vertebral fracture, and most commonly fracture of C2, C3 vertebrae is noted. And this fracture is called as hangman's fracture. Hangman's fracture dislocation. Then with regards to hypoxia, you all read now. Hypoxia is divided into ASHA types. A for anemic, S for stagnant, H for histotoxic, another A for anoxic. A for anemic, S for stagnant, and H for histotoxic. Let us quickly revise the etiologies, the most important ones for anemic hypoxia. Anemic hypoxia is mainly due to EO poisoning. Stagnant hypoxia is mainly due to any condition where ejection fraction of the heart becomes less. Heart is pumping lesser blood. Or I say heart failure like condition. Histotoxic hypoxia is mainly associated with cyanide poisoning. Anoxic hypoxia is usually associated with any condition where airways are compromised, or we say asphyxia is the mechanism leading to death, or we say the person has gone to high altitude all of a sudden. These are your important causes of different types of hypoxic death. Who has classified this hypoxic deaths into ASHA types? Name of the person who gave this classification of hypoxic deaths is another question. Classification of hypoxia into these four types was done by Gordons. Remember the name. Gordons classification is this one. Classification of hypoxia into anemic, stagnant, histotoxic, and answer this. This is a VIP question asked almost every year, either in one or the other session. These VIP topics should not be missed. You should cover each and everything right from the scratch till the complete topic is covered. Aise questions ko miss nahi karna. Okay. So the moment you see features like dilated pupil, dry mouth, decreased secretions, delirium, your poisoning is going towards dhatura. Dhatura. All the features are starting with D alphabet. This is another trick to help you identify. Then what are the other poisoning features? Let us at least revise the features. What is this delirium type in dhatura poisoning? The delirium is low muttering type. Low muttering ka matlab kya hota hai? The patient speaks indistinct words. He will keep on doing like this. You will not be able to make out as to what the person is trying to convey. Then other D's are like features of dysphagia might be noted in the patient. Features of dysarthria might be noted in the patient who has consumed dhatura seeds. Then features of dysuria. This one was the clincher in recent NEET-PG exam. Never miss this feature. Painful urination, which can progress to total absence of urination, anuria. There they give you dysuria or anuria. This goes with dhatura poisoning. Okay. What will be the temperature of the skin? Atropine leads to atropine fever, just like cocaine. Cocaine also leads to hyperthermia. This dhatura contains active principles as atropine, hyoscine, and hyoscyamin. Maybe a repeat question. They showed you the dhatura fruits and they asked you, what is the active principle in these fruits? Active principle is atropine, hyoscine, and hyoscyamin. So we are seeing all the atropinergic features, anticholinergic features. What will be the antidote of choice? Antidote is IV physostigmine is preferred one. Neostigmine is not able to cross your blood-brain barrier. Physostigmine is the preferred one. Let us move to the next question. A person died due to starvation, which is correct in this case during autopsy. So the person is not taking food. Food is not going into GIT. So what happens is, whenever food comes in GIT, this food stimulates the release of cholecystokinin, which is responsible for gallbladder contraction, and emptying of the bile happens. When the gallbladder contracts, it gets emptied of all the bile. If food is not present, CCK is not present, gallbladder will not contract. It will come distending and distending. Answer goes option. While what will happen to all other organs? They will decrease in size. Will decrease. Another recent repeat. Very lengthy question. The gist of the question was, a person has been taken to juvenile courts when the age of the accused will be always less than 18 years. Less than 18 year person in India legally is called as child. According to Juvenile Justice Act, according to this Juvenile Justice Act as well as POXO Act. The first line of these two acts are, child is a person less than 18 years old. दिस चाइल्ड कैन बी बोथ अ मेल चाइल्ड और अ फीमेल चाइल्ड. इज द बेस्ट आंसर गोज विथ ऑप्शन. नाउ जुवेनाइल कोर्ट्स आर प्रिसाइडेड बाय व्हिच रैंक ऑफ जज. आंसर इज प्रिसाइडेड बाय व्हिच रैंक ऑफ जज. नाउ रैंक ऑफ जजेस इज अनदर टॉपिक. Juvenile courts are usually presided by which rank of magistrates? I have given you one hint. Answer batao. Juvenile courts. Abhi aate hai us pe. Smith na? I am coming to that thing. The Juvenile Justice Act ek bar quickly revise kar lete. Because a recent question was asked. The key points of this. Answer is it is presided by Duniyadar. Amazing. कैसे था magistrate का hierarchy कैसे होता है magisterial courts का. Second class judicial magistrate, then your first class judicial magistrates. On top you have chief judicial magistrate, correct? It is the first class judicial magistrate. Thank you Vinod. Thank you Nishtha. So first class judicial magistrate is the rank presides juvenile courts. And there they are called as principal magistrate. Principal magistrate is the name given to first class judicial magistrates who presides juvenile courts. Usually this principal magistrate preferably should be a female judge. How it is constituted the juvenile courts? Along with the principal magistrate, what should be essentially present always is two female social workers. Who sit besides the judge. Two female social workers are also present along with this principal magistrate, and then the courtroom procedure occurs. Then the courtroom procedure. This first class judicial magistrates in metro cities, what is the name given to these magistrates? They are now referred to as metropolitan magistrates. Metropolitan. Suppose they frame a question. What they will frame, juvenile courts is presided by. Options will be principal magistrate, second class judicial magistrate, chief judicial magistrate. Answer will be principal magistrate. Because the rank is first class judicial magistrate all. Now let us do a quick recap of Juvenile Justice Act. Juvenile Justice Act. Chota sa act hai. Act to bahut lengthy hai, but two important point. This deals with child. No. Now child can be of two types. Child who is in need of care and protection. Like there is an orphan child who was roaming on the road. Now the policeman will catch the child. So this child is in need of care and protection. He has not done any crime. So this child will be taken care by the policeman. How? They will inform the child welfare committee that please take care of this child. Child welfare committee, after proper investigation done by the policeman, child welfare committee members will, they will transfer the child to children's home for their welfare. We have children's home under Juvenile Justice Act for welfare of the child. Another category of the child will be a child who has done a crime. So now legally this child is called child in conflict with law. He has done something which is unlawful. He is said to be in conflict with law. In conflict with law. With law. So now the policeman will do the investigation, and later on the matter will be transferred to juvenile court. After hearing, the child will be sent to a special home. For a period of 3 years or till the child achieves the age of 18 years, whichever is earlier. This is what happens. Now, what are the offenses which can be done by a child? They have been classified under this act into petty offense, serious offense, and heinous offense. These are the offenses which can be done by a child. according to juvenile justice act. Petty offense is any offense for which punishment in IPC is less than. Serious offenses are all the offenses where punishment in IPC is 3 to 7 years. Heinous offense kisko bolte? Wherever punishment in IPC is more than 7 years. Now we say the child has done a heinous offense. Best example of such offenses are rape offense or murder offense. Correct? Now there is a recent update that if a child means less than 18 year old person, has done a heinous offense. Now, if done by the child, now this child will be tried as adults. One of the recent updates. If any heinous offense like rape and murder, best examples. Heinous offense is any offense where the punishment is more than 7 years, as per IPC. I hope this is clear. Itni cheeze yaad rakhni. Remember this one. Petty offense, serious offense, and heinous offense are offenses under which act? Juvenile Justice Act. Now come to next question. Answer. This test is done to detect which state? Question twisted. Never try to mug up the answers of the question. So here the answer will go with blood state. So T-test, table tennis bat is red in color. For red stains, whether these red stains are blood or not, we have some microscopic tests. One T stains, another one is Takayama hemochromogen test. Correct? For semen sample, semen will be present in a boy, or I say boyfriend. Here the tests are B for Barbarios, F for Florence. Okay? We are not going into details of this. Number of questions cover. Details aapko pata honge, I think, all of you. This is again a VIP topic. Stain analysis is again a VIP topic other than agricultural poisons and your Datura poison. Answer. A farmer was brought to casualty with pinpoint people in grease secretions, garlicky odor. Which drug is to be used by the doctor for treatment? Pretty simple question. Now, meiosis is being seen. Secretions are increasing. Secretions can increase in the form of salivation, lacrimation, urination, diarrhea, then GIT distress will be there, and emesis in the form of sludge. And yes, this poison has got a garlicky odor. The poison which we are talking about is opium, and the antidote of choice will always be atropine. N-acetylcysteine is the antidote for which poisoning? The question aisa ho gaya ki har is being asked in every exam, N-acetyl, and recently asked in NEET PG exams too. Antidote of choice for PCM, paracetamol. What is the scientific name of PCM? What is the chemical formula of PCM? Acetaminophen. They can ask you a question like this also. There is acetaminophen toxicity. Which antidote to be used? So, pata hona chahiye. PCM chemical name is acetaminophen. Aagee sab aapko pata. What is the toxic metabolite produced by this PCM in the body? Toxic metabolite is N-acetyl parabenzoquinone, which is toxic to which cells? Hepatocytes, or I say toxic to liver. Is it normally produced? Suppose someone has taken all have taken PCM, na? Lots of PCM in these last 2 years. Suppose someone has consumed 800 milligram of PCM. Is this NAPQ produced? Yes or no? A leading question. Leading questions are questions which are allowed during cross examination part of a witness, answered in yes or no. So the question is, leading question for you all is, I have taken 800 milligram of PCM, the therapeutic dosing. Will NAPQ be produced in the body? Will this toxic intermediate, will it be produced? Yes or no? Answer is yes. But normally it is detoxified by our glutathione stores. What happens in toxicity? Now there will be too much of this toxic metabolite and our glutathione stores consumed up. Now it will produce toxicity to liver. Answer is yes. What are these questions? Questions answerable in yes or no are called leading questions. Even in therapeutic doses, NAPQ is produced. That is to be remembered. See, PCM metabolism, if you go into deep now, about 95% of the PCM is detoxified in the form of glucuronide and sulfate conjugates. ऐसे करके ये बॉडी से निकल जाते हैं सल्फेट ग्लूकोरोनाइड एंड सल्फेट कॉन्जुगेट्स बन गए. व्हाट अबाउट रेस्ट ऑफ द 5% पीसीएम? रेस्ट ऑफ द 5% मेटाबोलाइज्ड बाय साइटोक्रोम 2E1 पाथवे, CYP2E1 पाथवे. एंड दिस साइटोक्रोम मेटाबॉलिक पाथवे डन बाय साइटोक्रोम 2E1 प्रोड्यूसेस NAPQ, व्हिच इज नॉर्मली डिटॉक्सिफाइड बाय ग्लूटाथियोन स्टोर्स. आंसर टू द क्वेश्चन विल बी यस. सो in toxicity, what happens? The glutathione stores are consumed up, and to replenish the store, we give N-acetylcysteine, which the level of glutathione. A child consumes iron tablets by mother. Antidote. This is also a topic which has been for last 2 to 3 years. In fact, in PG exams, they have asked iron poisoning stages. We have covered in our regular classes. Iron poisoning is very, very important. Antidote of choice is desferrioxamine. This is in relation to acute poisoning. For chronic iron poisoning, the antidote will change to efavirenz. Trantine can be used in as a chelator in which poisoning events? Trantine as a chelator for which poisoning event? In any condition where there is excess of copper in the body. I say the person has consumed lots of copper sulfate, or I say the person is a case suffering from one of the autosomal recessive disorders, that is Wilson's disease, where ATP7B gene becomes defective. Treatment for Wilson's disease as well as increased copper is, you can give chelators of copper like trantine as well as zinc as well as penicillamine. Remember the three chelators for copper be removed from the body. Next one. Which of the following treatment need not be given in a carbamate poison? Sabko pata hoga, I think. Any of you must be aware of. आंसर बताओ जल्दी. Which of the need not be given in a case of carbamate poisoning? Carbamate poisoning. ऑप्शन तो पढ़ लो पूरा. Everyone is answering. Option तो पढ़ लो. Carbamate में oximes दे दोगे. Carbamates bind to both anionic and steritic site of acetylcholinesterase enzyme. Oximes का mechanism क्या होता है? They bind to anionic site. Will oximes be able to produce in a case of carbamate poisoning? Answer is no. Oxips, they have no role in carbamate poisoning, but they can be used in OPCs. Organophosphorus compounds ka mechanism kya hota hai? They bind only to steritic site. Now, auxins can come and bind to anionic site of the enzyme and can detach the OPC compound from the, and our enzyme will be freed up. This enzyme is the mechanism. In fact, auxins have got a mild anticholinesterase activity of their own. If you give this to a carbamate poisoning ACE, in carbamates, what has happened? Inhibition of acetylcholinesterase. You are giving a product which is not effective in carbamate poisoning because now the product cannot bind to the enzymatic site. In fact, it has mild anticholinesterase activity of its own. Patient condition will worsen. Got it? If you need now, we can cover this topic. Agricultural poisons completely during our special classes. I have planned on 1st, 2nd and 3rd of June. We'll be covering this topic, agricultural poison. Which of the following is the most reliable method of estimating blood alcohol level? A repeat question. Which is the most reliable method of estimating blood alcohol? Most reliable. Most reliable ka matlab kya hota hai? Most specific. Aur kaise pucha jata hai? How this question is asked? Which is the gold standard diagnostic test for alcoholic poisoning or alcohol detection? Answer will always be gas chromatography. Alcohol is a volatile substance. Alcohol is a volatile substance. Breath analyzers are not gold standard diagnostic. They are medical. They give medico-legal levels. They are valid medico-legally. But most reliable test for estimating blood alcohol level will always be gas chromatography because alcohol is a volatile substance. Correct now? This alcohol poisoning is again a very important topic. Common things are commonly asked. Like Dhatura poison. Dhatura is easily available. Alcohol is easily available. Agricultural pesticides are easily available. That is why they keep on asking questions from. Bromolecryuria is a feature of poisoning by of the following. Old question hai, can be asked as a new question. Can be repeated again. Bromolecryuria simply means, in one word, shedding of red color tears is a feature of which of the following goes with. Why? Because in OPC poisoning, what is noted is increased levels of porphyrins. Porphyrins in lacrimal gland. Person keeps getting tears, which due to porphyrins get a red color. Answer is OPC. Silver nitrate filter paper test is used for which of the following poisoning? I take a white filter paper. I bring it close to patient's airways or to the gastric lavage sample. The gastric lavage has been done. And on the top of the jar, I bring this white filter paper impregnated with silver nitrate. What I will notice is that the white filter paper has become black. I'm talking of which poisoning event? Answer goes with aluminium phosphide. Because aluminium phosphide, also called as Celphos, Celphos top tablets, on coming in contact with moisture, they liberate phosphine gas. Is this phosphine gas which converts your silver nitrate filter paper into black? Answer goes with. So, what is the diagnostic test for Celphos poisoning? Silver nitrate filter paper test. Answer this one. This one is also a question which is asked in all the exams, as well as all of the following are cardiotoxic poisons. Answer goes with curare. Always remember curare and conium. They are two poisons which belong to which category of poisons? Peripheral nerve poisons. Peripheral nerve poison. In total, we should remember the list of cardiac poisons. We can remember like this. A simple mnemonic which you read everywhere. Like this. Dawn has a queen. Reddy stands for Digitalis. O stands for Oleander. Oleanders can be of two varieties. Yellow color flowers are called Cerebra Thibetia. Oleanders can have pink or white color flowers. In Hindi, they are called Kaner. Pink and white oleander is also called Nerium odorum. N for nicotine. N for H for hydrogen cyanide is also sometimes classified as cardiac poison. A for aconite. And queen for quinine. Easy to memorize with the help of this symbol. So all these are important cardiac poisons. This should be remembered. Absolute contraindications of gastroclavage are all. Yep. It's a simple question. Answer goes with carbolic acid, which is also called a phenol. Because all other corrosives, they have a tendency to cause thinning of gastric mucosa and leading to perforations of GIT, mainly stomach area. But phenol has a tendency to leads to edema of gastric mucosa and makes the stomach wall hard and leathery. That is why gastric lavage can be done in spite of phenol being a corrosive. Misconduct in public place by a drunken person punishable under which of the following sections? Ek question maine pick kiya today. I have picked one question from your IPC. Answer. Misconduct in public by a drunken person is punishable under 5-1. Not A. What is A? This is also called McNaughton's rule. It deals with criminal responsibility of a mentally ill person, whether the person is responsible or not. This McNaughton's rule or 84 IPC is related to insanity. If the defense lawyer in the courtroom is able to prove that my client, during the commission of the offense, my client was a person of unsound mind. He was not able to understand nature and consequences of his act. And what he was doing was wrong and opposite to law. So he might get a benefit of 84 IPC. What is 201? Causing disappearance of evidence. Whoever is causing disappearance of evidence, like removal of blood stains from the crime scene. Removal of the dead body to remove the evidence. Causing disappearance of evidence by any means. In relation to doctors, what we should remember? In poisoning cases, you have done gastric lavage and you have thrown the sample. That is a very important sample from where poison detection could be done. So we have to preserve the gastric lavage sample and hand it over to policemen. Causing disappearance of evidence can be like non-preservation of gastric lavage sample, non-preservation of visceral organs in a poisoning case. 497 IPC previously was an offense before 2018, which used to make adultery a punishable offense in law, but now it is not a punishable offense in law as such. So just these four IPC, at least for today. Then presence of skin blisters is suggestive of poisoning by which of the following? Presence of skin blister is suggestive of poisoning by barbiturates, thus, comma, carbon monoxide. All these are differentials of your skin blisters. Your poisoning, barbiturates, as well as blister beetle, also called as Spanish fly or cantharides. Then second degree flame burns can also lead to antemortem red color blisters. Then blisters can be seen to postmortem putrefactive changes. Postmortem blisters will be black colored. All these are important differentials in relation to drugs. Remember, in relation to this insect, remember blister beetle, also called as Spanish fly or cantharides, then it is usually associated with second degree flame burns, and in dead bodies you can get postmortem black color blister. नॉट सीओ टू, नॉट कोकेन, नॉट आर्सेनिक. आर्सेनिक का अलग इफेक्ट होता है, डेंड्रफ पिगमेंटेशन एंड हाइपर केराटोसिस. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट स्किन ब्लिस्टर्स डिफरेंशियल. हाईएस्ट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ कैनाबिनॉल, कैनाबिनॉल और टू बी एग्जैक्ट डेल्टा 9 टेट्राहाइड्रोकैनाबिनॉल इज प्रेजेंट इन कैनाबिस. बट हाईएस्ट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ दिस एक्टिव प्रिंसिपल इज फाउंड इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग. This we have covered in our classes. Out of BCG, bhang, charas and ganja, which contains highest concentration of delta 9 THC? Sir goes with charas. Sir always goes. This is most toxic because it contains maximum cannabinol. Flashback phenomena is associated with the use of which of the following? Answer goes with LSD as well as cannabis. For these two poisons in relation to differential of flashback phenomena. For what is flashback phenomena? Getting the effect of drug even without actual intake. His actual intake was at 6 o'clock in the evening. Later on at about 1 o'clock in the 1 a.m. the person is showing you the effect of cannabis and LSD when the drug was not taken up. This is what is flashback phenomenon. Excessive sexual desire in males, known as a mixed bag questions. Excessive sexual desire in males is referred to as satyriasis. The same thing in females referred to as nymphomania. Masochism is giving pain to self. Voyeurism, also called as peeping tom, scoptophilia or scopophilia, is a punishable offense under 354 subsection A, B, C, D, four options. Voyeurism is a punishable offense under 354. C, 354 C. Very good, Sadhav. Stalking is punishable under 354 D. 354 A deals with sexual harassment to a female. B deals with act of disrobing a female. Which of the following is not a component of cyanide poisoning treatment kit? The correct answer. Correct answer goes with sodium bicarbonate. Not present. What is present in this kit, which is also called kit, used for cyanide poisoning management? It contains amyl nitrate kit given through inhalational route and IV route. Products are sodium nitrite and sodium thiosulfate given through IV route. The answer goes with sodium bicarbonate is given through IV route along with a diuretic to a patient. What is this process called? What is this process of management of this case called as? In one word, called as soda bicarb is alkaline substance, and we are using a diuretic. This is called alkaline diuresis, used for management of acidic drug poisoning. What is the list of acidic drug poisoning? Methotrexate, NSAIDs, sulfonamides, then B for barbiturates, for penicillins, for chlorpropamide, Then soda bicarb will be beneficial in any case where metabolic acidosis is occurring, like in a case of tricarboxylic acid antidepressants of this category. They have a tendency to lead to metabolic acidosis. So if this alkaline the form of soda bicarb. Answer this. Recent questions should not be missed. A physician doctor referred a patient to a radiologist. Some person known to the radiologist later visited the physician doctor with a thank you letter and money packet. What is true regarding the above situation? This is what is referred to as medical dichotomy. is defined as fee splitting between doctors by unwanted reference. Splitting between doctors is a unethical act on part of we doctor, medically referred to as dichotomy. Decent question. Rigette's test. Then the test for differentiating live births and stillbirth delivery. They are very important questions. Rigette's test is used for testing functional maturity of, you all must be knowing. What are the synonyms of Rigette's test? It is also called hydrostatic test. Also called as rotation test. Rotation. What is the principle of Rigette's test? Anyone? Weight of the lungs or something else? Lungs ka to dekhte hain. Kya dekhte hain? Weight of the lungs or something else? What is the principle of Rigette's test or flotation or hydrostatic test? Answer is specific gravity of lungs. Very good, Sadhu. Specific gravity of lungs is taken into account. Normally, the specific gravity of water. Pani ka kitna hota hai? 1. Anything which has a specific gravity more than 1 will sink in water, which happens with stillbirth deliveries. If I take out lung of a stillbirth fetus, here the lungs will sink. In a live birth where respiration has taken place and thereafter death occurred, now the lungs will float because respiration is in that fetus. Here the specific gravity is less than 1 of the lungs. Here it is more than 1. Now we have covered our snake poisoning nicely in our classes. This is again a VIP topic. Why? Because cases do come in casualty. In FMG exams, common things are commonly asked. Cases which come in casualty, those things are usually asked in you. So, cobras and your rats. They are two categories of snakes which are neurotoxic. Musculotoxics are snakes. And vasculotoxics are V for vasculotoxic, V for Y. So that's all for today. So tomorrow also there will be a YouTube session at the same time, where we will try to cover some other MCQs mainly concerned towards FM part. And then on 1st, 2nd and 3rd of June, we will have special classes in the evening, mostly from 8 to 9 p.m. Many people were wanting now, then will be the special classes. So I have planned it. 1st, 2nd and... isme I will try to revise your important images. Not cannot cover all the images, but yes, the most important ones we will try to cover. On 1st, 2nd and 3rd of June. These will be your special classes in Unacademy. Filed MCQ session kal karenge na, aur isme bhi karenge. These special classes may be MCQs hi cover karenge, but we will go in a like a chapter wise. Daily we will try to cover 2 or 3 chapters. So images, MCQs, all things we are trying to cover here. Images and MCQ sessions hi honge. Trying to cover all your high yield MCQ. So keep on working hard on. And don't let your confidence be low. Right now is the time now when you feel that you are not able to recall. It happens with everyone, not only students. With teachers too, we also forget. Forgetting is a natural thing. Don't overstress that you are forgetting. But yes, try not to forget by revising that. This is what we can do. To do a thing which we can do. Forgetting is a natural thing. Don't overstress. Till then, bye bye. See you all tomorrow, 8 o'clock.